So if you guys want to go to medical
school in Thailand through the first round, which is the portfolio round, this video is
perfect for you. Hi guys, it's Tini and today we're talking about books. So I've been getting a lot of requests to make videos on my admission process, and one of the biggest contributors of getting into med school is the books that I use. So first off, hi. I am a medical student at the Faculty of Medicine Ramathibodi Hospital. I'm currently in my year 2. So just basic facts on medical schools in Thailand. Usually in most schools, it's divided into 5 rounds for admission. I got in through round 1, which is the portfolio round, which requires me to apply using my high school grades as well as external exam scores like BMAT, SAT, IELTS. And also, interviews are a very big part in this round. So if you guys want to go to medical schools in Thailand, I will be covering the books I use from my high school courses to SATs, BMATs, and all the way to building my portfolio and how I prepared myself for the interview. We're going in an order that the books make sense most. So like, chronological order. The first book I would like to mention is this one. I feel like it's really good for just preparing yourself, for helping you decide what kind of university is best suited for you, because that's very important when you go to uni. It's not just about like the academics. You kind of have to consider your social well-being and all those stuff as well. So this one is like a pretty good guide to help you pick out your university like generally, but this one is based in the UK. For those who want to attend uni in Thailand, this might not be the best book for you, but for those that want to go to the UK, this would be a very good place to start. I went to an international school in Bangkok, RIS. In most international schools in Bangkok, they have these programs for you. There's like IB, APs, IGCSE, A levels, and all those stuff, which at my school they offered AP and IB, which brings me to my next point. I took AP biology and AP chemistry during high school. Here are the 3 books I would recommend for taking AP biology. First one is the Princeton Review AP biology exam. You guys can kind of see I still have my sticky notes here, still in a pretty good condition. I love this book because I feel like they did a very good job at explaining the contents. It's mostly very concise. There are very helpful diagrams in here. The drills they have at the end of every chapters are also quite like helpful, and they have 5 full-length practice tests, 4 in the book and 1 online, with complete answers and explanations, so I thought that was very helpful. The next one would be this AP Biology Crash Course. I feel like this is good for when you have already revised the entire course, but you just wanna like quickly read through what the main topics are. They aren't as like deep in terms of like explanations, but it's a very good book for summarizing and just, you know, going over. And the last one would be this one from Pearson's Campbell Biology. My AP Biology teacher recommended it. My friends that took AP Biology recommended it. I only used the textbook in there, but I heard that the test prep series is very good. And it also has brief summaries in there, so pretty good. I remember the diagrams being very nice. Usually it's like the to-go book for those who are taking AP Biology, so highly recommend. The other subject I took in school was the AP Chemistry, which is this book. This one's from Barron's, and honestly, Barron's is also pretty good as well. They're very popular. A lot of the questions I get is Barron's and Princeton's Review, which one's better? I feel like they're both very good at explaining the content, but I'm secretly biased towards Barron's because I feel like I understand better with Barron's. I personally don't really like the review and practice tests they give, but you know, having practice tests is still better than not having practice tests at all. Would recommend this one for explaining, and it has like practice tests here, so why not? This one has 7 practice tests, including 3 diagnostic tests, 3 practice tests, and 1 online. Next up, for the external exams. We're gonna start with SATs. For getting into med school in Thailand, you're only required to send in your SAT subjects. The ones that are definitely required are biology and chemistry. And in most schools, they give you the freedom of choosing either to send in your SAT subject mathematics 2 or SAT subjects physics, but then some uni requires like all four, so you gotta read the requirements very clearly. So we're gonna be talking about the College Board SAT subject study guide. So I initially had all four, but then I'm only left with the biology one because the other three I already sold them to my underclassmen who wanted them. Also, if you guys are interested in any of the books here that I can like physically show it to you guys can DM me if you guys are interested in getting them. I feel like these are good because these are made by College Board, which are literally the makers of the test. But I feel like they are a little easier than the actual test. So don't rely on these just to get like a high score in the test. Definitely try to do a lot of practice tests, even the hard ones. What I really like about these is that like you get the actual feeling of taking the actual test. It looks just like taking the SAT. So what you have in here are two real biology subject tests, detailed answer, explanation, and exclusive test taking tips. So that's nice. This is really helpful, and so are the other subjects. The next one is the SAT subject test chemistry from McGraw-Hills. They have a like, very good mock test, very similar to the actual test. I guess the same level of difficulty. Next up are these SAT subject books from Princeton Review. I had the Math 2 and the Physics, but again, I already gave it to my underclassmen. And for Biology and Chemistry, it was recommended from my friend who also got into the same uni. Just like every other Princeton Review's books, pretty good explanation for each concept. I feel like it's just a good book in general to resort to when you just need summaries and explanation of the content and some past papers to do. Actually, my bad. I do have a Princeton Review's SAT subject test. This one's in chemistry, but this one's really old. It's the 2011-2012 edition. The content isn't that much different, and you also get like practice tests from like years before. So if you guys are interested, definitely check that out. You can definitely DM me for this. Not bad. Coming up next is the Barron's SAT subject. I have this one in biology, and this one's 2008, so relatively old. Same mindset with the chemistry one. Maybe they might bring back the old questions and all that. And content inside is still very much the same. Yeah, and honestly, because I took AP Biology, and SAT and AP are both from College Board, a lot of the contents are like overlapping, so I didn't have to read as much. That's why I only did the test and then came back to the topics where I struggled in. But then there are some areas in the test that did not overlap with AP. That's just gonna be extra reading. And that's it for SAT. We're moving on to BMAT. It's probably classified as traumatic event in my head. I have the preparing for the BMAT physical copy, and I also used the BMAT Ultimate Guide before. The best way to practice your BMAT is just do past papers in the website, because those are like the real deal. The only downside is that they don't have explanations, so I would recommend you guys getting like one or two of these four, just because they have explanations in there. There are people that they kind of predict what the next year's test might look like. Those are pretty good too, because I feel like the level of difficulty is pretty similar. The Ultimate BMAT Guide 800 question, that's probably my number one recommendation for you guys, because I feel like they have really good tips and tricks, and they have very similar questions that is like a very good practice for you. But that book, again, I already gave it away, so I only have this one, which is also just as good, so DM me. Next up for IELTS, I have this one, Barron's IELTS Super Pack, which consists of like many books in here, like here. This one is really good because this is like the entire package. Another one that I would also recommend is the Cambridge English IELTS 10, because that one my friend used, and it was good because Cambridge was, like, you know, the maker of IELTS, so the mocks are pretty similar according to her. So yeah, you can also look into that, or you can just DM me for this. That's it for IELTS. Another very important aspect to getting to medical schools in Thailand in the portfolio round is the portfolio, hence, you know, the portfolio round. One thing that my uni had required me to do was write my personal statement. So I got you covered. This book, Get Into Medical School, Write the Perfect Personal Statement. It's pretty UK based, but then again, I feel like the systems in Thai uni are also pretty UK based. So I would recommend you using this just for as a general guideline. It kind of explains to you, like, what school admissions tutors are looking for, how to plan and prepare to write your personal statements, and how to develop a structure and content to maximize impact. It's a pretty good book for, like, the general rule of thumb for writing a personal statement. If you guys are looking for a book to improve your writing, definitely check this one out. The other really important aspect of getting into medical school is the interview, because for my round, they took interviews very, very seriously. We did it in, like, the format of an MMI, which is multiple interviews. These could be really helpful for you. This one's medical school interviews, and this one's succeed in your medical school interview. Really good because they kind of give you, like, mock questions of what you could kind of expect. Ranges from ethical questions to, like, tips and tricks on body language and presentation. Definitely prepare yourself for that. Don't memorize the answers from here, or don't prepare, like, a script, but just use these as guidelines because they can be really helpful, especially when you don't know where to start. Just flip through these. And this one's also really cool because it includes multiple mini interviews. Yeah, and it includes, like, MMI questions in here too. And last but not least, the UKCAT, 1250 UKCAT. Practice questions includes full mock exam. This one is for those who are considering UK. I don't know much about the UKCAT. I don't know why I have this book, but from my understanding, it's, like, it's one of those aptitude tests for getting into medical schools in the UK. Honestly, it gives off BMAT vibes. You might be interested in looking at this book and seeing if they have, like, questions that might be helpful for practicing. Again, if you guys are interested in any of these books and wanting to get your own copy, you can definitely DM me, or you can check out the links below. I have linked all the books that were mentioned in this video in the description box, so definitely check that out. Help yourself out, and I wish you good luck to all those that are preparing for admissions. I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button. Comment down below if you have any questions or any requests for me. Subscribe to my channel for more fun content. I do videos from vlogs to kinda educational videos like this, and beauty videos, makeup videos, skincare videos. So subscribe to look forward to those. Don't forget to turn on post notifications and click the bell icon to know when I upload. You can also find me on my Instagram. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!